would like to introduce you to my present and the rest of the world's future. I call it STEM.
Some people think that some of these things are sort of science fiction-y, far out there, crazy. But I like to say, okay, let's look at the modern human condition. If we think about it, we're actually recently arrived guests on this planet. Think about if the world Earth was created 1 year ago. The human species then would be 10 minutes old. The industrial era started 2 seconds ago. There have only been 250,000 generations since our last common ancestor, and we know that complicated mechanisms take a long time to evolve. So a bunch of relatively minor changes take us from broken off tree branches to intercontinental ballistic missiles. So this then seems pretty obvious that everything we've achieved, pretty much, and everything we care about depends crucially on some relatively minor changes that made the human mind. And the corollary, of course, is that any further changes that could significantly change the substrate of thinking could have potentially enormous consequences. Some of my colleagues think we are on the verge of something that could cause a profound change in that substrate, and that is machine superintelligence.
Artificial intelligence is a rapidly growing field of technology with the potential to make huge improvements in human well-being. However, the development of machines with intelligence vastly superior to humans will pose special, perhaps even unique risks. The United States have identified artificial intelligence as one of the key technologies that will ensure the United States will be able to fight and win the wars of the future. Potential international rivals in the field of AI are also creating pressure for the United States to compete for innovative military AI applications. China is a leading competitor in this regard. In 2017, the Chinese government released a strategy detailing its plan to take the lead in AI by 2030. Less than 2 months later, Vladimir Putin publicly announced Russia's intent to pursue AI technologies, stating, "Whoever becomes the leader in this field will rule the world." Most surveyed AI researchers expect machines to eventually be able to rival human intelligence, though there is little consensus on how this will likely happen.
Artificial intelligence used to be about putting commands in a box. You would have human programmers that would painstakingly handcraft knowledge items. But since then, a paradigm shift has taken place in the field of artificial intelligence. Today, the action is really around machine learning. So rather than handcrafting knowledge representations and features, we create algorithms that learn, often from raw perceptual data, basically the same thing that the human infant does. The result is AI that is not limited to one domain. Now, of course, AI is still nowhere near having the same powerful cross-domain ability to learn and plan as a human being has. The cortex still has some algorithmic tricks that we don't yet know how to match in machines.
Whichever government or company succeed in inventing the first artificial superintelligence will obtain a potentially world-dominating technology. By a superintelligence, we mean an intellect that is much smarter than the best human brains in practically every field, including scientific creativity, general wisdom, and social skills.
There's this illusion that time horizon matters. If you feel that this is 50 or 100 years away, that is totally consoling, but there's an implicit assumption there. The assumption is that you know how long it will take to build this safely, and that 50 or 100 years is enough time.
Sam Harris is a neuroscientist, philosopher, and New York Times best-selling author. He explains that one only needs to accept three basic assumptions to recognize the inevitability of superintelligent AI. Intelligence is a product of information processing in physical systems. We will continue to improve our intelligent machines. We do not stand on the peak of intelligence or anywhere near it. The problem with the race for AI is that it may result in poor quality ASI that does not take the welfare of humanity into consideration. Sam Harris worries that the power of superintelligent AI will be abused. If governments and companies perceive themselves to be in an arms race against one another, they could develop strong incentives to create superintelligent AI first, or attack whoever is on the brink of creating it. The Chinese, Russians, Indians, Israelis, Koreans, Japanese, and Europeans are at least as motivated as Americans to develop advanced AI. Currently, China is primarily focused on using AI to make faster and more well-informed decisions, as well as on developing a variety of autonomous military vehicles. Russia is also active in military AI development, with a primary focus on robotics. An arms race for an ASI could lead to authoritarianism. It could make it easier for political groups to shut down negative speech against them. It can make it easier for businesses to assert their rights over interests of workers, consumers and the general public. Philosopher Nick Bostrom expressed concern about what values superintelligence should be designed to have.
A biological neuron fires maybe at 200 hertz, 200 times a second. But even a present-day transistor operates at a gigahertz. Neurons propagate slowly in axons, 100 meters per second tops. But in computers, signals can travel at the speed of light. There are also size limitations, like a human brain has to fit inside a cranium, but a computer can be the size of a warehouse or larger. So the potential for superintelligence kind of lies dormant in matter, much like the power of the atom lied dormant throughout human history, patiently waiting there until 1945. In this century, scientists may learn to awaken the power of artificial intelligence. And I think we might then see an intelligence explosion.
Any type of AI superintelligence could proceed rapidly to its programmed goals, with little or no distribution of power to others. It may not take its designers into account at all. The logic of its goals may not be reconcilable with human needs. The AI's power might lie in making humans its servants, rather than vice versa. If it were to succeed in this, it would rule without competition under a dictatorship of one. There is a need to transition to more democratic forms of political decision-making. It cannot be assumed that AI will not work to strengthen the power of those who control it. Elon Musk warned that the global race towards AI could result in a third world war. To avoid the worst mistake in history, it is necessary to understand the nature of an AI race, as well as escape the development that could lead to unfriendly artificial superintelligence. Researchers in the field who believe that ASIs will be friendly want to help creating an environment that will make it possible for the ASIs to be positive. Many experts, however, suggested limiting the power of ASIs. To determine whether it would be acceptable to limit the power of an ASI, it is important to understand what it means to limit a superintelligence. It could keep any AI system permanently at a human level of cognition. To limit a superintelligence is not to try to make the superintelligence less capable. It means the superintelligence stays below a certain level of capability permanently.
Machine intelligence is the last invention that humanity will ever need to make. The machines will then be better at inventing than we are, and they'll be doing so on digital timescales. Now, a superintelligence with such technological maturity would be extremely powerful. And at least in some scenarios, it would be able to get what it wants. We would then have a future that would be shaped by the preferences of this AI.
There are several technological capabilities that could form the basic elements of a workable ASI. The cognitive element to the AI would be much like our own brains. These elements would not only have the ability to learn and comprehend, but also the memory to store all of that knowledge. The ability to think could include morality, ethics, rational thought, artistic creation, scientific experimentation, and especially the ability to work with logic. Another important element is the ability of human-like emotional responses, reason, and to communicate in terms meaningful for human beings. Whoever succeeds in creating the first superintelligent entity, they need to make sure that this new type of intelligence is democratized, understands people, and is able to communicate with them in some way. Bostrom argues that we might make a mistake and give this new entity goals that lead it to annihilate humankind, assuming its enormous intellectual advantage gives it the power to do so. The way to avoid this mistake is to create an open system and help it develop. Artificial intelligence is undoubtedly the future, and the possibility to create a friendly ASI is important, as it will have a serious effect on our future. To ensure the friendly nature of artificial superintelligence, world leaders should work to ensure that this ASI is beneficial to the entire humanity. In addition, it is important to test all logical goals before development of such AI. The AI programming would have to be open to access and limited to only positive uses, such as curing diseases or producing resources. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing, ringing the bell, and enabling notifications to never miss videos like this.